Hey guys, we're going live to recording session with GB Hutch.
Ben Fawcett wrote on the Paddy Power Facebook page, couldn't get into the casino with Trainers Paddy. We hear, but with our slick new casino app, there is no dress code. Just choose your game. European roulette. Drag your chips to, let's go with when I lost my virginity. 36. Then let her do a thang. And yes! Oh, so glad we waited, Stacy. Sign up and get five.
Okay, back to programming. You guys. I last left off before at a place where I was having issues with Twitch, and it seems to be slightly fixed now, but I don't know, we'll see. When. So yeah, I'm currently testing on my projects, and I'm currently developing the multiplayer side of the game, so let's get back to it. So I did actually add another link, and it's going to go to my notepad. So this is what I'm currently working on. Problems I have, let's just move up here a little bit. So it says, on player shoots, these are the problems that I've encountered so far. So the smoke is attached to player, smoke relative to player, not below. The guns aren't switching, the shotgun shoots too quick. Okay, so I was trying to tackle this problem last time, and we're trying to tackle it again. So, top 8 and 5, let's just check out. I'm going to change the music, also, just a bit more soul. Should put a bit classical on. Bear with me, and
great news for Spotify free users. You can now listen on
your. Also put a random classical music station on, turn it down a bit. An email, 1 minute. Okay, cool. So yeah, let's just test this out. Try to create a room. Let's just turn down the actual sound from the game. So we'll put our shotgun on. Okay, so another problem I just noticed is that we don't actually play the shotgun animation. Not so good. Is there a way I can actually zoom a specific interesting. I wanna be able to make my Okay, I'm just gonna make this a bit bigger. No, I'm not. Not too big. Because I don't want to be able to read this one. So, we need to tackle these issues. Shotgun shoots too quick. I think it shoots. Boom! I think 9-2 would be nice. We need to fire. I think that's fixed for now. Where is it? I think it's fixed. Fixed. Testing. Just needs a proper for testing. We have just lost a window, which is not good. Why is that? I see. So when I minimize my windows, they disappear in Twitch. It's weird. Very weird. Okay. So, what am I trying to fix? I'm trying to fix my unspawn player shooting quick. Maybe plan. Okay, we'll fix later. Shotgun shoots too quick. Shotgun and assault go reload. Help you. I hide. Maybe. Okay, the gun aren't switching. Okay, so we'll fix later. So what happens basically right now in the game is when I have the assault rifle, I'm not disabling the other weapon, and therefore it appears as I'm wearing, I'm wielding or holding two weapons. And we don't want that to happen. Well, I don't know. So we need to fix that by going into. We could just define it here, maybe. I think I wrote a function before. So I can just set up the assault rifle. Yeah. So it says here, weapon script. This it's not fine. Okay, so. I have to have this here. You can actually set up the assault rifle. And that should just fix that problem. Play. Cool. So I think it looks like. Alright. Yep. Okay, so when I'm switching the weapon, it appears as the shotgun prefab is not disappearing. It's a problem, obviously. Let's see. Send a switch weapon. Or weapon switcher. Set up a sword rifle. On set up a shotgun. Okay. Assault gun. I need to make sure that this is actually an object. It's actually a weapon. So I need to go. Shotgun objects. Tango Beaver. That's the name. I need to here. I need to check. There's also a rotation interference, radical, maybe. Okay. That's another issue I found when I was not streaming. Player hips, spine. Just click on it. Okay. Let's just apply that again. I want to see if it's actually getting called this weapon switching. If it is, let's go to Visual Studio. Play. Game, I got an error. That's cool. So still not getting caught. Whatever, there's a problem. I was positioned, was quicking it too quick. I might actually put something to come around. Multiplayer. Lobby. Next. I'm rapidly caused error. Didn't break game. So sender weapon switcher. Okay, so maybe that's why. So we send a switcher. What's the difference? Cyprus. To change a weapon. So when you change a weapon. Okay, hi, okay, let's just set up the shotgun. What is the definition? Assault, open offense, think it was false. There we go, we found a problem. Duplicate code. Sometimes happens. So, that should. There is a problem. The object is still not getting disabled. We should get disabled. And that's a problem. Oh no. Yeah, I see, okay. I think I fixed it then. Hit play. Okay, we're trying to create a game. Okay, so we're running a game. I still don't. There's like some issue with this during the rotation. Okay. So yeah, the weapon's now changed. Shotgun's a bit out of place. Maybe we can fix that. So just click on it real quick now. If you change it in the game, I can just grab the wire value and just paste it in there. Oh, alright, we can still check. So, something here must be. Doesn't appear to be any of the colliding objects. F and S. Okay. Yeah, everything else seems to be. Only problem that we might have is this. Right hand. There it is now. Weapon controller and the capture card. Yeah, this one here. It could be that it's preventing collision with like doesn't would you? What we're gonna do is we're gonna go pretty science and put on physics and see what. So the weapon is currently only working in conjunction with this. I think I could add a raycast to prevent this jet wrinkle from going on. I think I might do that. I think. Problems right here. Just showing. Let's start making like a log for it. Oh, that's not it. Problem. Okay, so the problem is now that it could be the raycasting function. Cast function. Raycast function. Okay, that's its log. Cool. So this here, let's just try and make this look a bit nicer. So wow, he's not letting me go whatsoever. Let's just rotate him. Okay, that's bad. Maybe I can scale the shotgun up. I don't know why it's not there. Let's just pause the game actually. Stop him from armor. So he's holding the gun a little bit. I think we could get away with that really. Because you guys won't. You only see from a top down view. And this doesn't. Which really like means that we don't get to see how he's holding it. Maybe okay. So first of all, it's too small. The gun is too small. This thing here is too small. Can I get away with that? Get away with something like that. Let's just look at him. So he looks a bit more realistic now. Okay, Yeah, so it looks like he's holding the gun. Guys can't see me, okay? Which is zero speed. Anyone who is watching this. I don't grab this on Twitch. Okay, yeah. So if you see the guy. Oh god, everything's upside down. Guy. You look from above. Okay. Health UI. That's UI. Play a UI. So if you see for now, right now, it looks like from above, the guy is actually holding a weapon, which is cool. It's good. So I need to record those values what I've just taken. And the easiest way to do this. It was just like a copy and paste. Maybe there is some kind of thing. Sometimes I feel like I edit something in the inspector and runtime, and sometimes I want to save that. Those values. The thing is, when I hit play and I finished debugging the scene and I've changed the transforms, is that it gets reset to the original position that was set before in runtime. The problem is with that is I don't have the ability to save those values what I do in runtime, and I find it a really painful, not painful, but time-consuming task to actually grab those values from the inspector in runtime and paste them, copy and paste them into like Notepad, so that I can, paste them back into the editor and then not in runtime. So I feel like this should be like a save function or like a copy function or something, and you can like prepare. And then save. That would make life so much easier. I don't know why you need to do that. Or maybe there is like something like that already. But for now, I just use Notepad. So let's hit and pause. Wasn't playing it. Fortunately, he's not one. He's not in the scene, I mean. The easiest way that I found out was to click on the button. To click down. Let's see what we're doing. I need a drink. Wow, it's getting. It's like 6:30 here already. Okay, cool. So if I go. What was I doing? Go back to the notepad. Oh, yeah, I was posting those values in for the shotgun. I don't know how that's gonna fit. It won't fit the bullet direction that much. I think it should fix it, because there was a problem where sometimes. The bullet would spawn on a weird angle, and that would cause the bullet on a long distance to shoot upwards. Even though it wasn't intended, which is a problem, because you don't want it to happen. Oh, you guys can't see what's happening right now because of my notepad, sorry. So basically what I'm doing right now is just I'm just copying those values that I just grabbed from my notepad and just copy and paste them into the inspector in non-runtime in editor mode, you can say. Maybe there's a perfectly good reason, maybe it's to stop preventing mistakes, but it is just to make sure like everything's right. Yeah, I'm talking to myself, but I'm probably on screen. Right, oh, let's move my notepad back up. And the stream as well. And let's just decrease this unity window. So now we have. The player with shotgun. And he should be able to hold it a little bit better. Apply changes and delete from the scene. We'll see what happens from here. Commit sparrow me. Come on. He's a high plus. Robin Thousand. Okay, that's weird. It's so weird. And I don't know why it's doing that. Okay. That's fine. What I'm going to do now is move it back. We're going to join. Yes, we're going to join. Oh, I don't like that. I don't like the fact that it's Jared as well. Here we go. How? Go. Get rid of the Jared. There must have been the. Oh! There's the recast. It's Jared just. Okay, so. It is. I just need to see what's happening in my shooting. We don't actually, when we shoot, we don't actually assume. We don't. When I go into my rotating scripts for the player, I need to find the rotating scripts. When I go into the rotating script, what happens is I shoot a recast and then I look at the mouse, wherever that mouse hits, and then I try and I straighten the ray out. That's the same. What does it say? We don't care about that. Care about this bit here. And maybe that's the problem. So do we have more than just a player playing recast? Okay, then that shouldn't affect. Yeah, it shouldn't be effective. I really don't understand why I get this jitter movement. I have lots of seagulls outside. It's weird. So I'm not getting that jitter movement. I don't get that. I'm only getting the jitter movement. Actually, I'm not getting it that bad now. Maybe it's because I had I'm streaming and I've got other games up in the background. Maybe that's fine. Okay, cool. So that seems to be fixed. We're still in online mode. We'll just check if it works in offline mode because the whole point is kind of re-scripting and reintegrating is because we want to reintegrate into the game. Reintegrate into the reintegrate single player and multiplayer. And see, there's one instance. I'm glad I drew a movement again. Maybe it's stats. Okay, yeah, that's because we got that drew a movement because we're running like 5 FPS. And that's mainly because I'm running on my CPU and I am hosting, I'm just streaming on Twitch. Basically, that's why. Maybe I should have run Twitch on my graphics card? Because sometimes your games and applications don't automatically run on my graphics processor. Yes, it's kind of annoying, but sometimes it's just good to use to play my games in, on my CPU, like test my games on CPU, because then I can basically I can test on the lowest spec and just check out frame rate, then using a graphics card, which then. You know what I mean? Anyway, yeah. So I think it seems to be working. There is a bit of jittery movement. I'm just going to check one more time that the ragdoll and the colliders are not kind of like fighting with each other and causing a problem, because that would be a problem. Let's see. So just bounce up and down right now. Maybe it's causing a problem with the player. How do I follow? Can I follow? How do I follow? Just zoom in a bit more. Follow the player. Animations are slow as well, aren't they? It should be quicker. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Oh yeah, we're less than 16 on the go. Okay, cool. So everything that seems to be working, just not everything seems to be working, but we do have that issue with the 360. That could be fixed in the future. I don't write that now actually. So so lower rotation, legs not working, not rotating correctly. Incorrect rotation. Desired rotation. Not rotating. Not identifying. Anti. Wise. And stuff. Cool. Okay. So everything else seems to be working. Oh no, not everything seems working. So we have fixed this one. I'm just gonna move it out of the bottom. I'm gonna move this because we don't need the wall. Guns aren't fixed. It's fixed. Testing. So it means like thorough testing. So this will probably be like we have like multiplayer sessions every now and again. Anyhow. We show a multiplayer level like lower rotation, probably later on. The smoke is attached to the player, it's not relative to the player anymore. I did have some kind of configuration. Oh, I think this is my old shooting script. And this did have it, I think. I'm not sure if I was instantiating or what was happening, really. I think I was just throwing it back in. So, let's just check that out. Oh no, the script's messy. It's not so messy. Oh. Okay, it's not in this one. My bad. I think it might be in my files. So, files, passport. Nope, oh, wrong. Passport. Don't worry, it's not my passport, my actual passport. So let's do. And crumples. Oh, got top down mate of multiplayer. This might be. That might be under my work. Alright. Multi FPS. It's an FPS lag. Top down. Yeah. Okay. This might have the scripts that we. Okay, it's gone. Maybe if we did date, a normal date. Okay. I think this one should have it. Should no scripts. I think it might be under new. Okay. Let's try that out. So we have. Interesting. I'm going to. What was I looking for? Okay, smoke. So we need to look for. Let's close everything. Wow, I should have saved it. Anyway, she selected one and she shot them. She put it in. So we get my old script. I shot the. So I took the smoke out of this. How did I get this? That's my next question. Okay, so smoke, shotgun smoke. So we specified which jar we wanted of the smoke pack or smoke pack. So this is basically the shotgun muzzle flash, and inside the muzzle flash you got the smoke and the sparks and everything else that controls the muzzle. And I think this is the smoke bit, which is making the jets. So we grab that smoke, and then we say play. Oh, if we're already playing, we need to stop it and we need to restart it. And then we also set the position to go because. And then we also play the full thing. Maybe these two like conflict with each other. Maybe we should just not. Oh no, because once this is out, once this is null, once parents know that it's no longer in contact with this. Okay, great. So I'm going to just if I can make it near, I will. So go back to manager, and this is the multiplayer. First of all, let's just close all these scripts down. Let's close all. Can't do that, can I? Let's just do this one. Close. And we're going to ragdoll. I know what we need. Shotgun, do we still need you? Not right now, because we're working on the actual. Maybe I can just move the uni window side to this side now. Hey. Okay, let's move you over here like this, and just, let's just get better. And this is the game, and then we've got an ounce. That's my ounce. My ounce will go, ooh. Okay, we're working on this boat right now. I like it, as you can see. Nothing perfect, yeah. So now, we need to just, this is my old single player one. This one here, hold on. Alright, old script, and I'm just gonna hold copy. Let's think about where about I want to put it first. Probably need all the shotgun stuff. Do I need to move that anywhere closer? No, I don't. But it's nice on its own. I'll do it here, just after I set the bullet spawns. You could say. Let's just see what we've got here. So first of all, we need to see what I define as. It's easy. Smoke, gun, transform. Okay, so we're grabbing. I'm assuming that the smoke is actually attached to an object, game object. Yeah, that makes sense, because particle systems can't exist on their own unless they're like stuck on a game object in uni. Yeah, that's kind of how it goes in uni components. So we're gonna say setting. I think we need to do with the assault rifle as well. Set up smoke for shotgun, making it will relative. Okay, so we say hey, okay, we want to create a transformer. That's working, let's just clean this up a bit. So, everything else is working in here. Shoot gun ray. Yeah, fine, off state. We got anything that relates to, like, getting the transform. And I do get the bullet transform somewhere. Here. So, these are like spawns, so, like, I guess they can go underneath here. It makes more sense. Shotgun will say, hey, okay, so private. Transform shotgun smoke, spawn. There. As simple as that. That's cool. So now I'm going to just check on Facebook because my friends must be. No, they didn't. Okay, I'm not. I'm on. So now I just need to go and what is that? So I've just added the transform, and now I need to add this code here, and we need to find the child first. So first of all, we need to find the... Oh, okay, so we've got smoke up here, and this is a particle store. Particle setup. I guess I could put the spawn in there. Shotgun, bullet spawn, pump audio, smoke, spawn, smoke, particle. Shotgun. Particle. Prefab. I'll get component. What have I said here actually? So I said to smoke transform because shotgun particle prefab dot transform dot get. So we get the transform. That's right, and then we get the child. What? But that's not right. We don't want. You want two things here. Well, particles. Okay, so we're just gonna grab. Shotgun, particle system. Okay, so we have particle system, we have shotgun smoke. Particle. Okay, let's kill. So let's smoke particle. We need to get the transform on this particle. What's the best way to do it? We have spawns down here. The best way to do it would be to get spawn. Okay, so we're going to say private transform shotgun underscore spawn parent and smoke underscore parent. Nice. I am the owner of this child. So first of all, we want to say, okay, hey, look at me, smoke parent. Ooh, it goes shotgun particle. Shotgun particle prefab. Not get component. And then we're going to say, okay, I want to get transform. Get child. One. Hopefully that's not causing any problems. Get component. Get child. Okay. So you need to call the transform to get the child first. Okay, that's fine. That's understandable. So we now got the parent. Do we have... We don't have the actual smoke yet. We haven't got there yet. So now I want to say shotgun... smoke. Should we fill it out? I did say I want. Because you get component every time is expensive. So trying to do it just once saves a lot of time. So think about trying to slap this into the awake function or get this get component function. I think it should work. So I would say shotgun underscore particle. Parent particle smoke underscore parent dot get component and say particle system. Okay, cool. What I'm gonna do now is I think I'm gonna start breaking things. Oh no, you don't need to yet because it's still in the. Oh, I just got assault and then got shotgun. Obviously. Ah, I got the crown! Ah! So we've got shotgun, particle, creeper, part system. Now we just need to call it, which is cool. And I just. There's already to jump down here, like, quicker. It's like, oh, there's a page down. Oh, nice, page down. Page down is nice. Page down is your friend, guys. Triple shot. So when I shoot the shotgun, I'm gonna say, hey, okay. Let's start this smoke animation. I don't want to do that just yet. I want to do it down here. Do the rest. Oh, I see. So, what I did was I made this more generic and made it so in the future I may want to change my weapon. So instead of a shotgun, it could be like, I don't know, some lasers or something, and maybe just I pass information through my states, because this is a state man, this is a weapon state manager. I did this because it makes life easier when I want to add a new gun, basically. So what I need to do is basically I need to grab the transform the shotgun. Okay. We say, hey, okay, guess what? It's getting a bit lengthy now. But I want to say, hey, okay, guess what? I want my transform. Oh, maybe we can get twice. Maybe we triple shot. Can I just do it in number two? But that means I have to copy and paste this big long code. What I was going to do is I'm going to create two functions with the same name, but with two different parentheses. Maybe I should do that. Maybe I shouldn't. I just don't think this is getting a bit lengthy. This thing here. I'm thinking like maybe we should add something else. Or maybe we should. Okay. Well, I'm gonna go and just keep the same one function and just do this to make it look a bit nicer because. Oh, I don't like that. That was quite ugly. I really don't like that. Okay, let's change. Let's change that part. Maybe I'll do like this. Let's see what happens like that. Like that. Like that. Oh, audio. Audio source. So jump like that, and then go here. Okay, jump like that. I still don't quite like that. Just because I really like the nice. It's kind of like a ruler, if you didn't say. Okay, I don't like that, so I'm just gonna go to the end of here for now and say, okay, what am I controlling? I'm controlling my. Basically, a transform, isn't it? Is it transform? Smoke transform.parent. Oh, that's a game object. Shotgun. Smoke. Oh! Yeah, okay. Shotgun parent, okay. So you always need to set the shotgun parent at the actual. I don't know. Set the shotgun parent at to the. To where we're shooting the gun. Hard to decipher my information that's going in my brain into actual English and then try and explain at the same time. So I got like I'm threading, kind of, I'm like completely processing. I read an article saying that multitasking is actually really bad for you. It's not. I'm not doing that hardcore multitasking. It's talking more about the fact that many researchers and like creatives have like lots of tabs open in Google Chrome and like it's the switching all the time and decrease productivity and then like anyhow, so let's go back to the shotgun stuff. So now we need to spawn. Making something like so lovely now, it's getting really I'm just talking about, I'll just go around in circles. I just need to implement it straight onto the team. Let me be quiet for a second. Got my bearings. Okay. So what we need is transform. We transform for the smoke. Transform. Transform parent. Okay, cool. We also, yeah, I think we should start breaking this up a bit because it is getting a bit lengthy. I'm going to do it about here. So then it still gives me that kind of ruler kind of thing. Cool. So we've got transform and we also got the particle. Particle system. These are all private, like, these can't be touched. I hope they can't, right? Oh, they should be. Smoke, particle. Smoke, particle system. Yeah. Play self-explanatory, and that's all we need. So now, when we come down here, I'm going to say, hey, okay, guess what? We want you to... smoke muzzle. Muzzle smoke. Okay. I like everything more or less being named the same. Well, it looks neat if you saw the same muzzle. So I'm going to rename it just for my... sanity. Muzzle underscore smoke. Did I put a capital? Okay, yeah, smoke. Smoke. Transform. What's it called? Transform. Instead of trans. Sounds a bit weird. So muzzle. Muzzle. I'm just going smoke. Particle. Particle. Go down here. Muzzle, particle. Muzzle, smoke, particle. Smoke. Particle. I can't spell particle. Is that right? Oh, try next to me. I spelled it right anyway. Okay, so we've got a small particle system. So yeah. So we need. Yeah, so we're gonna handle the smoke and say, okay, guess what? I'm gonna we're handling smoke. We need to put it into like a different. So we'll say shotgun. Smoke particle parent equals not smuzzle. I need muzzle. Muzzle smoke transform dot parent equals no. I tell you what, I can actually write a small function because I want to use this eventually for my assault rifle. So what I'll do is I'll just say smoke handle. Smoke particle handler. So yeah, okay, handles the smoke that comes out of the gun. Why? What should I put why? Why? Because when because. Particle prefab is attached to the player, therefore, when played, particle doesn't really get is it affected by get affected by. Well, velocity, but instead, local and player. Okay, maybe I should put. I like inside here, I like nice inside. So, the next step is to actually write something. So, I need to. I'm grabbing this transformer, so okay. Transform. Okay, and let's say. Factor 3. Position, so position, and let me say, okay, smoke rotation, and we want to say, is that all we need to say? Yes, we do, okay, is that added? So then we want to say, okay, guess what, we want to say, parent. Parent. Say smoke parent. Smoke parent makes more sense to me. Smoke parent dot parent equals no. Say okay, smoke just handling smoke. I'll say smoke parent, parent okay, and smoke parent dot position equals and position smoke position smoke parent rotation equals smoke smoke rotation. I mean, say smoke parent. Okay, now we need to go and get onto the actual particle system. We didn't actually add this particle system, but we're going to now. We're going to add it at the end, because there. So we'll say smoke, particle system, particle system, particle system, system, one, particle, okay, smoke, particle, smoke particle. It's fine. Okay, smoke. Smoke particle play. And then we'll see. Okay, that's fine. I've done it. I've done it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so this is gone. Smoke. Maybe a bit long. Sometimes longer functions make more sense. Because you can slay more, okay? As long as it's not too, like, if it's not a massive sentence, like, I am Glenn and we are from the galactics. The space you've never been to before. Okay, that's a bad joke and that was a bad accent. Hopefully no one was here to hear that. Smoke parent. Okay, I'm writing the values in. So what I need is natural transform of the shotgun. So I've got shotgun. Oh. Yeah, okay, I forgot. I don't want it to be relied on. We'll see my transform. Okay, so we'll say unsmoke. Unsmoke, particle handler. Smoke. Those are smoke transform. That's confused. It's easier. Otherwise, I'll just lose my. Smoke and then. Smoke drop. Position, rotation, and then the particle. So the particle is here. This is smoke. Okay, great. Great. A bit long, but it will do. It will sort me out. So now, we should get some errors eventually in here. In my uni. Hopefully she gets. Yeah, got error. That's right, just while I waited. So, it says here, guess what? You've got a new function, and you don't create the same. You create a function, or you have a function, and it doesn't have enough arguments in this case. So we say, okay, we're gonna fix this, and say, okay, guess what? We're gonna add more. We're gonna say, do you? I'll add into private. Ooh, getting lost now. So this is not mine. I'm gonna close it because I don't need them. Well, it is mine, but I don't want them. Say, guess what? I need you to be able to be accessed outside the script. I can't know, but that's why I need this. I need both of these actually. Maybe I should create some property fields. Could do that in the future. I'm gonna do that right now because time is of the essence, really, and to a point. And I've got like three or four weeks to complete a whole game, which is like, I'd say like 50% done. Oh, about 75% of the code's there. It just needs refining to work properly. And that's going to take a long time, really, because there's a lot of testing and people are seeing bugs and stuff like that. Anyway, I'm not going to get into the detail. But I need to also get the transform, what I also created. So, particle system, smoke, yeah, got that. I need to find the parent, which is also here. But I need to call this open shock on parent so I can actually access the script. Okay, so let's just see what was the requirement. First requirement. Come on, man. Okay, let's go down here. Sometimes it tells us to stop working. It's just right. But so okay, WM manager dot. Oh, it's working now. Shotgun transform. Where's it? Shotgun smoke transform. Shotgun smoke parent. Okay, let's hit that. And WM manager dot. Smoke particle. And that's it. That should be it. So I'm saying, hey, okay, it's my parent. This is the smoke I want you to use. Because in the future, I could just copy and paste this and basically just change these variables so that the weapon shoots a different particle and or a different light. It uses a different light. And it uses a different audio. And that in the long run will help me, I think, definitely. So, let's just try and test this out. Hopefully it should work. If not, I'm gonna cry. From what I know, or from what I probably just then, it should work. We need to save that first. Save. Control S is your friend. Let's just move. So you got all these errors. You got a lot of errors, like warnings, should I say. I got a lot of these when I'm programming. What tends to happen is that I'll program, like I do like a hack. A few days on like a day of programming, and then like towards the end of the night when like my brain processing powers I decreased, then all my energy has like more or less depleted in my brain, I just focus on fixing these little errors. But yeah, let's go back to playing the game or debugging the game. So let's play it. We should the smoke. Oh, why is it? Oh, okay. So now, you have the smoke. And the smoke is... Is it... Let's just put war and see what happens. So the shotgun smoke is not actually immune. We have reference to it, and we don't have reference. We have an errors. Okay, smoke. What is the problem? We don't have a reference to it anymore. You see? Local. Oh, I just found one of the reasons why things are working the way they should be working. Got plan awake. Plan awake. We don't have plan awake. Maybe that's with all the. I don't know. So. Maybe it's player on awake functions. This is a good thing about having a notepad, because sometimes you realize problem outside of when you're trying to think of it. So, yeah, it's not local no more, and that's rather annoying. Maybe we should get the game object. I don't know. Do you have reference to it? That is the problem. I'm just trying to figure out what's happening. Smoke position equal shotgun. Up position. No, it doesn't. That's why, that's the problem there. We shouldn't actually use, it should be spawning at the gun, at the player's position. No, she's just like saying, oh, let's spawn at my parent, my smoke parent, and my smoke parent is the one that needs to be moved around. Also, the rotations in the game update, that's because this area as well. Maybe it should fix it. So if you go to your shotgun, I don't know, where's it? Spawn parent. Yeah, okay, maybe it's not. Is that an array? Oh, it's a game object. It's game objects. Should I go to spawn? Oh, transform, okay, so I'm gonna put transform. I'll fix it. So we put play. And this should go now. Still got that problem, it still fires, but I guess. Got a bullet. Boom. Oh. Oh, wow. That is insane. Okay, so we don't want that to happen, do we? What we need to do is we need to get two different positions. So first of all, we need to get a transform so we can update that transform. Okay. We need to get... We need to get the smoke transform parent. Get the smoke transform parent. And move and rotate. But we also need the player's rotation. So we also need the play. We also need the spawn transform to update position as a reference. As a reference. Reference for the scope. Okay, so yeah, let's put more self explanatory again. Basically, my problem was I was spawning the smoke, and I was setting the position. But what I did was I was grabbing the gun. I was telling it to move the smoke to move to that position. So I was grabbing the gun and I was telling the gun to basically its parent to move up in the hierarchy and not have a parent anymore. That, and then update the position with its own position and its own rotation, and then maybe play as particle. But the problem behind that was that, you know, I was basically just left my gun levitating in midair. And to fix this, I need to be able to reference that spawn, but not change that spawn, because that spawn gets changed elsewhere when the player rotates, for example. We don't want that to happen. We don't want to be modifying the gun to become unattached from the player. So we need to add another reference saying, hey, okay, we are going to say player, we'll say player position. Player position, player rotation, we're going to say player position, player rotation. Oh no, we'll say bullet spawn position, we'll say bullet. Spawn position, something. Okay, we've got bullet spawn position, bullet spawn rotation. So bullet spawn rotation. Spawn rotation. Okay, yeah, I'm just starting to break these things up a bit. So, what I'm going to do is going to sort this right around a bit, just a second. So, it makes a bit more sense. Like, well, okay, we've got smoke in one section, and then we've got the bullet spawns, play positions, where you call them, and another. Next, we need to change this up here. So, instead of it being we need to say something else. Okay. We also need to grab the bullet spawn position. And right now, it's a shotgun bullet spawn. We need to add another one saying spawn. We need another one saying transform spawns. Bullet spawns. Bullet spawns. Beach spawn and bullet spawns. For each spawn and bullet spawns, then you want to shoot in that direction. Yep, that's fine. What's this here? I don't. I'm gonna close it off. I don't know what's going on. I did close up. Close Mars. Play. What each? We got errors. Why is it expected? Why is it expected that? Oh, okay. We deleted it. That was a problem. Okay. Don't worry about that. So many words, so many words. So let's back in the zone. So we're not doing a single shot. Just gonna close that down, we're getting confused now all the time. We're doing the bullet spawns, so we need to change this up a bit in a minute. We also need to feed in. Bullet spawners. Okay. So we can just feed it in from here. We don't actually need to feed it from this. Which saves me more headache in the future. Let's just re-add this to say smoke particle. Shotgun spawn. Okay, this is, I'm getting a bit confused now. So we have the bullet parent. Yep, it's fine, fine, fine. Okay, so we've got smoke, bullet spawn person. Okay, cool. Public, we need to make this public. But hide and expected because I don't want my level editors doing anything to touch it. Okay, so let's try this in a shotgun. Where was I writing it? Oh yeah, I was writing here, so everything else is fine. So from W and manager dot triple shot triple. Hang on. Why are those public? Are they public? There's a lot of public fields on here, and I don't really want them to be public. Do I really need all these people like to push up? Okay, well, yeah, we do need them to be public. It's insane the amount of it's not insane, but when my intelligence comes up with a lot of functions from outside the script, and that's kind of bad. We'll fix that in the future. Refine. But for now, it's fine. So WM manager, and we'll say chop chop. Okay, intelligence don't work when you want me to work. Chop chop. I don't know. Bullet. Bullet spawn parent. So that'll be like WM manager dot bullet. Shotgun bullet spawn? No, not. No. Shotgun spawn parent. Okay. I don't like how intelligence is not working. Come on. What rotation? Okay, I'm just gonna comment these out for now. Okay, but debug. Debug.log. Warning. Chrome smoke. Particle. And the have no code. Or doesn't get called. Okay, let's just put that. Just stop me in the future. Like I might like go downstairs, have some food, and then come back up and be like, oh no, what's happened? Like, why is it not working? There. Boom, look at my debug log and it'll tell me. Future preference. So WM manager dot hopefully it should work now. Triple. Why is my intelligence not working? That's insane, right? Okay, let's go to Unity, and we will just close. This is what happens sometimes when you have Visual Studio and Unity VS. Sometimes it'll just like lose its reference. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna open it up again. Hopefully it doesn't on Twitch like lose its. Hopefully you guys can see when it's back open the Visual Studio. Load up now. It might not work, it might not. Visual Studio, let's do something. Okay, so it's not. Oh, here it is. Prepare solution. Ooh! Very nice. Hey, solution to work. Oh, maybe not. It's not working. Okay, so close this. Oh. Pause Visual Studio and add a screen capture. Ooh, changing the room. It's small. I don't like that. How do I screen? How do I change the order? There must be a way to change the order. I got down. Oh, yeah, there we go. Drag it down, drag it down. Cool. Let's just change this to something. Do this down here, but so you guys can see what's happening. If anyone's watching. I wonder if anyone is watching. Oh, there is. Hey. Don't know who you are, but hey. Yeah. So, let's go back. I just check Twitch and just make sure.
Cool.
Okay, so I just hit myself on Twitch. I sound so bad. I've been talking for a while now, and I get really hungry. I'm not fat. I'm just getting hungry. And like, hey, stop getting sidetracked. That's not bad. Okay, I think I do need a break. Get to the point where I find it hard to concentrate, but I'm going to plot on for another 10 or 20 minutes, just to get a few more. Just to try to get this done, basically, because I don't want to leave it, you know, I don't need to explain, but yeah. So, before the intelligence wasn't working, which is a shame, it's just a good guy. Triple shot saves me from, there we go. Oh, and we probably just lost it now. Okay, so we've got bullet. Oh, I remember how to get your intelligence ups now. Like, if it disappears, you press control dot, I think, and it gets up your intelligence. It's a shame. Okay, so, dot, smoke, parent. Yeah, that's fine. Let's just put out a new line, make it veneer. Let's close it as well. And let's put this. W and manager dot. This. Particles is part. So we just put Okay, we've lost the reference again, which sucks. We're just gonna go up here and just see what happens. So we've got muzzle particle, muzzle light, muzzle light. Where's that muzzle? Shot line. I'm loving this music. Should turn out. Star Wars. I'm quiet for 2 seconds. For like 5 minutes, so I just write this. Push it down. Oh, I'll get confused.
Every day, right?
I don't have that. Bullet object spawn parent. But it's not. The parents are... I'm just copying that, that's what I had. What difference does that make? Does it make any difference? No, it doesn't. That's not good. So we have the muzzle particle. Yeah. Muzzle light. Yeah. Audio, yeah. Damage and parent of the smoke, and then we have parent of the particle. I mean, actual particle. And bullets on this to kill. Like one smoke parent, smoke particle. Smoke parent is actually kind of off putting me, I think. I think I should put, maybe next time, I don't want to go around and rename everything, but next time I'll just use some like smoke transform parent, maybe. I don't know. Okay, cool. So now. Should work. Spawn rotation. Bullet spawn rotation. It's not complicated. And then. Yes, okay. Sorry for not speaking, I just really want to get this done. So, smoke handler. Okay, so my next thing I'm going to do is. I'm actually add this one here, so I'm going to say gun smoke. Smoke parent will be. Smoke transform. And then the next one will be. Smoke pack. What was this smoke pack? Smoke particle, then bullet spawn to
fade.
Okay, sorry about that, guys. I was AFK because my girlfriend came in and she didn't cook me tea. So I go to. I got banged at 8. As soon as I had a rest, I could feel my brain throbbing. And now I can feel it throbbing like so much on that wall. So this is like the time I should be like finishing off now. Or at least having a break. I'll finish off and then I'll use it while I'm going to come back and some English just. Vicious. So I'm going to go. Bullet spawns. We have the shotgun, because this is a triple shot function, we need to ensure that we only feed in one of those positions and rotations. Generally, it's going to be. Generally, we shoot. My shotgun right now shoots. It's offset on the left, it shoots straight in front, and then offsets on the right. So it's like a torch or like a triangle effect. I don't want to get this one. I don't want to get the offset. I just want to get the straight forward vector of where I'm shooting. And this is me. A bullet spawn, and this is going to be. This should be bullet. Let's get my bullet. Bullet spawns, and I'm just gonna go one. Oh, transform. Dot position. Oh, it should be just dot position. You don't have to get transfer. That's just an extra call. We don't want to do an extra call. It's kind of modding around. We don't want to be modding around. So, bullet spawns on rotation. Hallelujah, that should work. I will cry if it won't work. I won't cry, but we'll see. So, you guys should be able to see on Twitch that we're about to test. Let's just move everything around. Let's just play. How to play? Play Unity. Come on, Unity! We have a fire! Shoot! Uh oh! Did you see that? We have an error. I hate errors. It didn't tell me. I think it's this one. Let's just read this. It'll tell me here what's wrong. So it's out of range. Should be. Sucks. It recorded 277 is gunpowder con. And it says that bullet spawns 1%. It's not working. Shotgun underscore bullet spawns. I don't understand why it's not working, and that's a really big problem. A really, really, really big problem. Bullet spawns. 012. It's not like it's 11 or anything. I don't think it is. This is a raise at the index. Bullet spawn. See, it works in here. Bullet spawns works fine. For each bullet spawn, one. Dot position. Should I just do this and see what. Oh, you guys couldn't actually see. Okay, so 2. Damn it! Why is that out of range? Zero try zero and see what happens to zero. I should fix it for now, I think. If it doesn't, I'd be like curious to see if I know why. Why is our range? Let's just check. If. Not able to know. It's just some why it's not working. We're not flying while we're down off, I'm guessing. Flying right there. See, it makes out of range exception. Oops. Bullet? I missed one. Triple shot. Maybe he's just getting lost in the house for a while. It's getting lost. Okay, so it is kind of working. I need to make sure that. That's a problem. I don't understand why it would be a, it's really weird. You have to search that up actually. Oh, you guys like actually see what's happening. So my problem was that I was trying to reference this component, where is it? Shotgun bullet spawns reference. Yeah, but for some reason when I did that, it was not giving me the right effect. Nah. Like it was like spit out a no, and I don't know why I was doing that. Which is something I have to look into. Right now I'm prepared for a break and I really need some food. Okay, so now we're getting there. So see how the smoke is coming out of the gun? The gun looks a lot more realistic. Maybe we could. Okay, I would like it, ideally. I'll just show you guys. So if I hit play. And not a super weapon. You can see that the shotgun comes out of the gun. It's not getting the vault. Let me just see. Okay. It's cool and fit for a sniper. A very cool fit for a sniper. But the thing is, the problem is, what is the problem? The problem is that it's just not perfect. Maybe a good refinement to make now would be to grab the current velocity of the player. I think there's a quick way to do this in the toggle system. So I'm going to quickly prefabs and go to resources and then find a player. Okay, so I'm going to go to player. And I'm going to go down here and I'm going to find. I'm trying to find a part. The sniper effects. Yeah, I was gonna say they look quite like a sniper effect. But I'm gonna try and change it up a little bit. It's a sniper smoke. I'm gonna change it to. Because what happens if I change the world? Apply. Okay, let's apply. See if I'm gonna change it to that kind of. Okay, yeah, okay, that's fine, that makes sense. Okay, so, let's try again, make the gun to go down, just try and see. Keep this one. Go down, and fire shotgun, prefab, lane on. Sparkle missile fire, and we want it to not clear. Okay, let's see how this one. Smoke local. We want it to repair it. Bossy. Bossy. Yeah. Inherit a bossy. See if that works. If not, I'm just gonna call it quits for now. And hopefully it's gonna change that. We're just gonna change it to. You can call it quits, yeah. Okay. Good. It looks more or less than before. We now have. So, what I've done in this thing is I've painted up this crystal a little bit more. I've added a function where the player can now shoot. He shoots slower, which is totally not bad. So, yeah, we added this juggle to shoot super quick. We added switching the weapons. We also added the smoke. I think what is next is to this one here. Shotgun and rifle. Then I'll have to check that out. Get these, and I'm gonna say goodbye for now. So that guys, thank you for watching my Twitch. Peace out. I need to find out how to close it first. How to close on Twitch. Okay, yeah, peace out guys. Peace.